Installation instructions for Arthur Flury phase break NS25. First is preparation of contact and messenger wire. We have to ensure that there is no stagger on the contact wire, and the maximum stagger which is permissible is plus minus 50 mm, and we have to ensure that there is no twisting on the contact line. Hogging instructions. Hogging can be determined by taking the average of two masts A and B and X that we have to determine. For getting that hogging height, we have to go to the middle of the span and with the help of a spring balance raise the contact wire by 120 newton or 12 kg. Now the contact wire which is raised up can be measured with the help of a scale, and thus we can see how much is the hogging that has to be kept for the neutral section. Now comes the alignment of that adjustment jig. Now place the jig across the track on a flat plate as shown in this picture. You can see this red direction. Now adjust this separate level so that this comes to the center. Now ensure that you are standing on the same direction, and now rotate this jig by 180 degree and again adjust the separate level so that it comes to the center. With this we ensure that the our level of the track has been stored in the in this jig. Now we'll see the installation of messenger wire insulator. First, with the help of a telfer or a pull lift, take the load of the catenary wire. Now after marking on the wire with the help of a binding wire, cut this wire very smoothly with the help of a hexa blade. Now file this wire so that there is no stranded wires on this wire. Now insert that four collar socket and ensure that the distance between that end wire and the center of that pin is not more than 60 mm. As you can see in this picture, it should be not more than 60 mm. Now we will see the installation of phase break body on the contact wire. Now place this first. We will see that there is no kink on the contact wire where this neutral section has to be installed. Now place this whole neutral section body on the contact wire and fix the splice so that it comes on the full grip of the contact wire, as you can see in this picture. Now after doing this, we tighten all the screws. Now here this shows that we have to see to ensure that this wire clamp should come to the full length. Now tighten all the screws with the help of a torque wrench, and it has to be tightened with 50 Nm. All the screws, since it is a new installation and for the first time it is being installed, so all that screws and nuts has to be installed, retightened 3 times, so that this being a new copper, that grip of that splice should come in a good contact with the contact wire. Now similarly use the counter nut again with the 50 Nm force with the help of a torque wrench. Now fix all the screws, and this has to be done on both sides. Now cut this contact wire with the help of a cutter. And now the extra wire which is coming inside has to be bent with the help of a wrench by 30 to 45 degree. and this has to be done on both sides. Now note this insolation direction. Now what we are doing, we are specifying the Hawking level, now which we had measured earlier, and we have to raise our whole neutral section body x height extra than the actual height of the contact wire. Now this we can do first with the help of the droppers to get that desired Hawking level. So first we will, with this four droppers, we will adjust the Hawking and fix the screws. Now we will take out this jig and adjust this turn buckle so that this level comes to the center. Now by this we are ensuring that our neutral section is coming in parallel to the track. Now we'll go to the other element. Now you can see that now this direction has changed from red to yellow, and again with the help of this turn buckle we will adjust so that this levels come to the center, ensuring that we are leveling our neutral section body with the track. Now we will mount the runners. Similarly, put the runners on top of this installation jig, and now tighten these screws and ensure that this has come with the full grip of the contact wire. Now tighten all the screws with a torque wrench with 50 Newton meter, and again the counter should also be tightened with 50 Newton meter. All the screws should again be tightened with 50 Newton meter of the runners, and then in the end the strengthening rod, it should be again tightened with 50 Newton meter. The counter should also be tightened. Now similarly we will do the same on the other side of the section of the element. Tighten all the screws again with 50 Newton meter and ensure that all the counter nuts has been tightened. Now similarly we will repeat the things which we have done and do on the other side also. After this we will check the how this section, this neutral section has been installed by gliding our separate level across it, so that we can fine tune if something is not perfect. Now we will fix all that counter nuts of the turn buckle, and so that this doesn't come loose because of the vibration, and we should secure it with the help of a wire also. This is a very important and safety feature which has to be taken care. Again cut the extra wire, and similarly lock the nuts also of this droppers. Now again check the alignment with the help of a pento, and now we can see here there are two okay. Green one is okay, which shows that it should be very perfect. Maintenance guidelines for Arthur Flury phase break NS25. First we will see the maintenance of isolators or insulators. You can see that with the passage of pento graphs that insulator rods will be worn out, and once this wear is 13 mm and 2 mm of the diameter, it means that we have to rotate it once, and with the help of a wrench we have to rotate both the rods simultaneously and on the both sides also. As you can see here that we are rotating on the both side, and you have to note the direction that the rod has to be rotated inside. Both the rod has to be rotated inside, and you have to note the direction. So you have seen that we have moved one point, and with again passage of pantographs, these again rods will be worn out. And similarly, we can rotate this rod 5 times. So you can see that direction of we are rotating always the rod from the in the inside. And once we have, after that we have to replace this rod with a new one. So we have to ensure that it doesn't get worn out, so that this fiber is exposed. In that case also, that we have to again replace this rod. Now, maintenance of runners or skids. Again, here you can see this is a profile of a new runner, and with the passage of pantographs, this will be worn out after some time. And once that thickness become 2 mm or 1 mm, then it means it has to be replaced. And for replacing, we have to remove the old skids and then place the installation jig, and then again put this new runners and tighten with the this.